Welcome back to another module of the same lesson, How Many Squares? In the previous module, we learnt about the area and perimeter of square and rectangle. Now, we shall see what are the things further we are going to learn in this lesson. Yeah, shape E is here. Alright. Okay. Now shape F you can find out, this is easy. So 4 complete squares are there, it means 4 you have to count, then ignore 1 by 4 and take 3 by 4 as complete one. So 4 plus how many 3 by 4 are there? There are 4 3 by 4, 4 3 by 4 filled squares are there. So all 3 by 4, all 4 3 by 4 will you will take as one full square. So 4 already fulfilled squares plus 4 3 by 4 squares, and which we are considering as 1. So 4 plus 4 is equal to 8 square centimeter will be the area of F shape. So what is the area of F shape? Area of F shape is 8 square centimeter. Okay, you try and solve this. This is for you. Area of shape D is equal to 5 plus half into 2. 5 plus half into 2. So half into 2 is 1. So 5 plus 1 is equal to 6 square centimeter. Then area of shape E. Area of shape E is equal to 18 plus half into 6. That means half filled squares are 6 plus 0. Now 0 means that is 1 by 4th. These we are considering as 0. So plus 0. So 18 plus half into 6 how much? 3. So 18 plus 3 how much? 21. Okay. So if you can't see the answer here, 18 plus 3 you can find out and you can write the answer. Okay. Let us see. Okay. Now you can see a question here. Let me read it. Which has the bigger area? One of your footprints or the page of this book? Now this book means your maths book. Okay. So they are asking which one has bigger area, your footprint or page of your maths book. So answer is page of math magic book. You can easily compare your area of your foot and area of the page of the book, and you will find that which one is bigger. The next question, which has the smaller area, 2 5 rupee notes together or a 100 rupee note? So answer is 2 5 rupee notes. You can take a 100 rupee note and you can take 2 5 rupee notes at home, and you can find out the area, which one has a smaller area. So 2 5 rupee notes has a smaller area. Okay, so next one. Now here is a question for you. Is the area of yellow shape more than the area of blue shape? If yes, why? Okay, so there are two shapes on the screen, you can see, and first one is square, other one is triangle, first one is yellow shape, other one is blue shape. So area of yellow square is equal to side into side is the formula to find out the area of square. What is the formula? Side into side, side is 3 centimeter, 3 into 3 is equal to 9 square centimeter. Area of yellow square is 9 square centimeter. Again, triangle, you can see measurements are given. Area of blue triangle, area of blue triangle is equal to half into base into height. Formula to find out the area of triangle is half into base into height. So half into base, base how much? 7 centimeter. Height is 2 centimeter given. So 7 to the 14, half into 14 is 7 square centimeter. So area of blue triangle is 7 square centimeter. Area of yellow square is 9 square centimeter. So area of yellow shape is more than the blue shape. Okay, let us move to the next slide. Next question for you. Is the perimeter of yellow shape more than the perimeter of blue shape? Why? There was a square, yellow square, and there was a blue triangle. We found the area of both the figures. Now we shall find out the perimeter of both the figures. So perimeter of yellow square is equal to 4 into side. We know the formula to find out the perimeter of square, 4 into side. So side is 3 cm. So 4 into 3 is equal to 12 cm. So we got the perimeter of yellow square, which is equal to 12 cm. Now let us find out the perimeter of blue triangle. Perimeter of blue triangle is equal to sum of all sides. Easy formula for triangle. Sum of all sides means perimeter of the triangle. So here also sum of all sides we are doing, addition of all sides we are doing. So perimeter of blue triangle is equal to 3 plus 7 plus 3. So if you add all these three numbers, we get answer 13 square centimeter. Okay. So it is printed here square centimeter, which is actually wrong. It should be 13 centimeter only, not square centimeter. Okay, that's a printing mistake. So you can say that perimeter is 13 centimeter of the blue triangle. All right. So perimeter of blue triangle is more than the perimeter of yellow triangle. Yes, because perimeter of blue triangle is 13, while perimeter of yellow square is 12. So which one is more? Perimeter of blue triangle. So perimeter of blue triangle is more than the perimeter of yellow triangle. Okay, so let us see the next one. Now coming to the next slide, let us see, find the area. Okay, they are asking to find us the area of these different figures and shapes. So first of all, first shape is square. Okay, so area of square is equal to side into side. Okay, on your screen it may not look exactly like square, children, but when you are writing in the notebook, you have to draw a proper square with the help of scale and pencil. All right, so let us find out the area of square. And area of square is equal to side into side. So how much is the length? That is 3 centimeter is the length of the square, or side measurement is 3 centimeter. So 3 into 3, 9 square centimeter is the area of square. Then area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. So length is 6 centimeter and breadth is 4 centimeter. All right, breadth is 4 centimeter. So 6 into 4, how much? 24 square centimeter is the area of rectangle, while area of square is 9 square centimeter. All right, so in this way we can find out the area of any shape. So this is a homework question for you. Find the area of that given rectangle. So you can draw this rectangle in your notebook and you can solve and you can find out the area of this rectangle. Area of the rectangle is equal to length into breadth. So find out the length, find out the breadth, and then multiply, you will get the answer. Next, find the perimeter of the following. Okay, so let us find out the perimeter now. We found the area of some figures. Now we will find out the perimeter. Okay, so here you can see perimeter. We are asked to find out the perimeter of a square. Again, it doesn't look like a square, but on screen, but you have to draw a complete square in your notebook. So each side is 4 centimeter. Okay, 4 centimeter is the side given because there are 4 squares. So perimeter, each perimeter is equal to 4 into side. So 4 into 4 is equal to 16 centimeter. 16 centimeter is the perimeter of figure A. Then again, figure B, find out the perimeter of figure B. This is a homework question for you. I hope you can solve this now. find out the length and breadth of that figure, and then you will get the perimeter. Okay, perimeter of rectangle is what? Perimeter of rectangle is twice into length plus breadth. Okay, remember the formula, twice into length plus breadth. Find out the length, find out the breadth, substitute the values in the bracket, add both the numbers and then multiply with 2, then you will get the answer. Come on, you can try it. Okay, let us see the next slide. What are they asking? Question is, draw a rectangle and divide it into 2 rectangles. Okay, we have already drawn a rectangle. You can see a rectangle is there. Now we are going to divide it into 2 rectangles. How? Just you have to draw a line in passing or going in between this rectangle. And now you can see in one rectangle, there are 2 rectangles. So we divided one rectangle into 2. All right. So this is this in this way we solved the first question. Now next question, draw a rectangle and divide it into 2 triangles. Okay, so how we are going to do this? We are going to divide this rectangle into 2 equal triangles. Rectangle we have already drawn. Now let us see how we are going to do with triangles, how we are going to draw triangles. Okay, so here we get the answer. So a line you can see in between the rectangle, and this line forms 2 equal triangles. All right, this way you can divide a rectangle into 2 triangles. And children, use pencil and scale. With the help of pencil and scale, you can draw proper diagrams in the notebook, and then you will easily understand all the concepts. All right, so this was about drawing rectangle and dividing it into either 2 rectangles or 2 triangles. All right, so let us move to the next slide. Okay, here you can see another slide. So very first question is there, draw a rectangle and divide it into 2 rectangles and 2 triangles. Okay, in a single rectangle they are asking to draw 2 rectangles and 2 triangles. So already we have drawn a rectangle. Now this rectangle we are going to divide it into 2 rectangles and 2 triangles. Okay, seems interesting. Let us see how to do it. Okay, all right, so this is the first line which we have drawn exactly in between the rectangle, and this line is dividing this rectangle into 2 rectangles. All right, 2 small rectangles. One is the big rectangle and now there are 2 small rectangles as well in this rectangle. Now let us see about the triangles. This is now also easy. Here comes the line. Okay, so this line divides this one small rectangle into 2 equal triangles. All right, so in this way you can answer this question. Again, draw this rectangle and these lines carefully in the notebook. Let us turn to the next question. Now let us read out. Here is a rectangle of area 20 square centimeter. As you can see, a big rectangle, long rectangle like a ruler, and the area of this rectangle is 20 square centimeter. Now how you got the area? By simply counting also we can get the area. By simply counting the squares in this rectangle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 on the lower side, 10 on the upper side. Together 20 square centimeter is the area they have already given. Now let us see the questions based on this complete rectangle in the next slide. Okay. So, as we discussed, that there is a rectangle with area 20 square centimeter, and based on that, there are some questions. Let us see. Draw one straight line in this rectangle to divide it into two equal triangles. What is the area each of the triangles? So we are going to divide this rectangle into two equal triangles, and then we can find out the area of the each triangle. Remember, children, the area of this complete rectangle is 20 square centimeter. If we divide this 20 square centimeter exactly into half, we will get the area of the triangle as 10 square centimeter for sure. So let us divide this, and here comes the line, and this line divides this rectangle into two equal triangles, and the total area of the rectangle is 20 square centimeter. This line divides this rectangle into half. So each half, that is each triangle, is 10 square centimeter. See here, I have written a straight line can be drawn as shown in this figure to divide rectangle into two equal triangles. Okay, so area of each triangle is equal to half into area of rectangle, right? So area of rectangle we already know how much, 20 square centimeter. So half into 20 square centimeter. So half of 20 is 10 square centimeter. Easy. I hope you got this one. So you draw this carefully in your notebook. Alright. So let us see other example in the next slide. Okay. Now here is another slide. Draw one straight line in this rectangle to divide it into two equal rectangles. So draw one straight line in this rectangle to divide it into two equal rectangles, and what is the area of each of the smaller rectangles. Okay, so here you can see this line coming from down, and this line divides this rectangle into two equal rectangles, two smaller rectangles. So they are asking what is the area of each of the smaller rectangles. There are two rectangles in this big rectangle, and they are asking area of each smaller rectangles. So very first, we need to know the area of this big rectangle. So what is the area of this big rectangle? This is the same rectangle from the previous example, and the area of this big rectangle is 20 square centimeter. Okay, 20 square centimeter. Now if you divide 20 square centimeter exactly into half, that means you will get 10 square centimeter. So what could be the area of smaller rectangles? Yes, 10 square centimeter. Okay. So this I have explained here in written manner. Area of each smaller rectangle is equal to half into area of bigger rectangle is equal to half into 20. Area of bigger rectangle, as I told, 20 square centimeter. So half into 20 is equal to 10 square centimeter. So area of smaller rectangle is 10 square centimeter. This is the answer. Alright, so these are the some things from this lesson, how many squares and we have included in module 2, and remaining part of this lesson we will continue in the next module. Till that time, you complete this module by writing in your notebook properly, try to understand, and write all the examples, complete your homework properly, so that you will get enough practice. Alright. So with this, let us complete this module. Let us conclude this module. I hope you understood everything. And if you did not understand anything, you can go through this video again and again. Alright. Okay. Bye. Thank you.